today we represent the First Amendment and the violation of Edward Snowden's freedom of speech. I am Emanuela.
I am Teodoro Cacadeus.
So, the Bill of Rights established on the First Amendment that Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise of Europe or abridging the freedom of speech or of the press, or the right of the people peaceably to assemble and to petition the government for redress of grievances. However, this important right was not respected with the American citizen Edward Snowden. According to Snowden, was an ex-NSA analyst, and in 2013 he leaked important and secret information related to the surveillance program that the country uses to spy on the American population in several countries in Latin America and Europe, using servers from companies such as Google, Apple, and Facebook. Therefore, he disclosed all of the information into the internet and later to the huge press of the whole world. Then, on June 13, the FBI director Robert Mueller said a criminal investigation was underway against Snowden. On the following week, the U.S. government filed a criminal charge for espionage, theft, and conversion of government property.
After leaking the documents, Edward Snowden published a manifesto in a German newspaper, which made points for the separate for the following: critics of NSA and GCHQ, which has surveillance programs of civilians. He made a threat of freedom of speech and open societies, which is program offers. He wanted the suppression of information, and he proposed a fight against surveillance programs. In his manifesto, Edward Snowden stated that agencies such as NSA and GCHQ, as stated before, are threats to privacy, as well as citizens' right to freedom of speech. Some governments break the limits of privacy and morals by spy civilians, thus suppressing and intimidating people to express themselves freely. His manifesto also: this is not only dangerous for human rights, but it also distorts the truth of information, which is vital for public importance. According to the First Amendment of the United States, the Constitution of the United States, it is a right of the citizen to speak freely without government interference, which is currently being disrespected with these five agencies. Since the government has a program of mass surveillance, it can manipulate and restrict people from information or truth, additionally restricting people from sharing ideas that involve the government. Therefore, Edward Snowden leaked information, according to his manifesto, because the society cannot be restricted from the truth, even despite from governmental agencies.
The exposure affects inside and outside the country. The problems that happen inside the country are: the US-based IT companies faces a crisis, losing $2.5 billion. Also, the President Obama needed to restrict the powers of NSA surveillance system to prevent more problems. The main problem is that the NSA surveilled the citizens without a court order. So when they were revealed by Snowden, that was the main point that the government needed to fix.
Outside the country, we have another problem, because Putin said Russians don't have the same surveillance system because they have to follow a protocol before spying someone, that court order that I said. Brazil canceled a planned visit to the US in October 2013, in addition for a deal for US jets. This was the jet that Brazil would have, but they canceled. This is the FA-18 Super Hornet. Brazil wanted the Gripen, which is a Swedish soft jet, the JSAS-39 Gripen. Germany also tried to spy the US themselves.
For the conclusion, Alex, this will be your source information. For conclusion, Edward Snowden called himself a legal trumpet after he leaked CIA documents, including a warrant for his arrest from the federal government of the United States. This link not only got attention from US media, but the whole world, with the whole world as well. Countries turning their eyes to the case because the documents leaked involved other countries such as Russia, China, Brazil, and several other countries. Overall, this has become a memorable case, which changed our vision about surveillance programs and the rights given by the First Amendment. It ultimately made the world reflect on how we should protect individuals' rights before the government's oppression.